magandang tanghali po sa ating lahat. Gusto ko pong i-brief kayo on two things, or update na lang, no? First, ay nag-conduct kami kanina ng preliminary investigation for multiple murder and frustrated murders against Congressman Teves together with 6 other correspondents. Hindi nag-appear si Congressman Teves, neither his lawyers, pero nabigyan siya ng subpoena sa bahay niya at saka sa office niya sa Kongreso. Pangalawa, we have been telling the public that despite the recantation of the shooters, we assured everybody that we can still successfully prosecute these cases. And I would like to share with you one of the several vital evidence that we have to prove the involvement of the respondents. We now have in our possession a copy of the DNA examination result conducted by the FBI over some specimen recovered doon sa sasakyan na ginamit ng mga bumaril, no? And nag-match yung sample na nakuha doon sa sasakyan at saka yung nakuha mga blood stains doon sa compound ni Governor De Gamo. Dahil if you can recall, some of the shooters sustained the gunshot wounds also. At may mga dugo na naiwan doon sa compound. So nakuha po ng mga investigators yung sample ng mga dugo and minatch po nila doon sa ibang specimen na na-recover sa sasakyan. And the DNA examination results point to the positive identification of Osmundo Rivero, si Gonyon Jr., at saka si Isturiz. And finally, regarding the progress of the terrorism case against Congressman Teves, among others, I do not want to preempt the statement coming out from the Office of the Secretary of Justice, but what I can tell you now is that it is moving forward, and very soon we can have a better and clearer picture sa outcome ng proceedings ng National Terrorism Council. And so far, the evidence will point to a definitive conclusion that a terrorism case will be filed against him and the others, which I do not want to name for now, and I give that privilege to Secretary Remulla. So maraming salamat po at magandang hapon.